From Studio B, this is WGALA Brainbusters. Now, here's your host, Rich Rosen.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to our vibrant studio and engaging show. Now, our last match featured Bermudian Springs and Hempfield, and as you know, only one team can progress, and Hempfield emerged victorious. Who will be victorious today? Will it be Lancaster Catholic or Carlisle? Well, the answer awaits us, beginning now, because here comes today's opening round. We have 10-point questions, a little easier to get the competition started. So pick up your signaling buttons and let's let the competition begin. Hybrid employees must return to the office 4 days a week starting March 1st, according to a January 2023 memo from CEO Bob Iger. For what company is Bob Iger the CEO?
Disney.
Disney is correct. Blind from the age of three, he created a system of raised dots still in use.
Louis Braille.
Louis Braille was the gentleman, yes. Iceland's closest neighbors include Norway, Greenland, and Scotland. Which of them is closest?
Elias? Scotland?
No, sorry, that's incorrect. Zach Finn or Isaac? We stumped you on Greenland. It's only 260 miles away. It first appeared on a bronze 2-cent piece issued April 22nd, 1864. It's still found on your pocket change. What is this four-word phrase? Sophie?
Mint?
No, sorry. No, Isaac.
In God we trust.
In God we trust is the four-word phrase we're looking for. Correct. Human beings have lungs. Fish have gills. What are the small holes in the surface of leaves through which oxygen and carbon dioxide are exchanged? Isaac?
Pores.
No, not pores, but a great guess. Any idea, Carlisle? We stumped you on stomata. On July 20th, 1944, Colonel Claus von Stauffenberg left his briefcase during a meeting. The briefcase exploded, but his intended victim did not. Who was von Stauffenberg trying to kill?
Adolf Hitler.
Adolf Hitler is correct for another 10 points. In 1709, Alexander Selkirk was rescued and became an instant celebrity with his tales of being thrown off a cliff by a ram and being so lonely that he danced with cats. Daniel Defoe wrote a novel about him. What did Defoe call him? Elias.
Robinson.
I need the full name.
Swift Family Robinson?
Nope. Great guess. Sorry, Isaac.
Robinson Crusoe.
He's the one. Correct for 10 points. It's renowned as a site for an alleged 1947 UFO crash. In 2022, Atticus.
Roswell.
Roswell, New Mexico. In 2022, they had a 75th anniversary of the crash. In January 2024, the U.S. Secretary of State traveled to Israel to ease tensions. Who is the current U.S. Secretary of State? Finn.
Anthony Blinken.
He's the one for 10 points. Good for you. It's a musical composition in a fanciful or irregular style. In 1940, Walt Disney used the term when he combined animation. Finn.
Fantasia.
He combined animation and classical music. You are correct again. Singing voices come in various ranges, including soprano, alto, tenor, and baritone. What woodwind instrument also comes in soprano, alto, tenor, and baritone varieties?
Saxophone.
The saxophone does indeed. Libraries use the Dewey Decimal System. What number is used as the base of a duodecimal system? Zach.
Two.
Pardon me?
Two.
No, sorry, incorrect. Atticus.
12.
12 is the correct answer. Yes, Oregon becomes the 33rd state. Charles Darwin publishes On the Origin of Species. Silver is discovered at the Comstock Lode in Nevada. John Brown is hanged after seizing the armory at Harper's Ferry. What's the famous year? Isaac.
1848.
No, sorry.
1864?
No, you're both incorrect. Sorry, it's 1859. In 1942, because of the threat of a West Coast attack, it was moved to Durham, North Carolina. The attack never happened, so the next year it returned to Pasadena, California. What is this granddaddy of all bowl games? Atticus.
The Rose Bowl.
The Rose Bowl in Michigan wins over Alabama in 2024. It's been in the news recently. The Presidential Records Act requiring the preservation of White House documents was passed in 1978. Whose collection of secret tapes played a...
Nixon.
Nixon, Elias, you are correct, played a defining role in a scandal that led to the act. Richard Nixon is the one. The esophagus, aorta, and inferior vena cava pass through the muscle that divides the chest from the abdomen. And we were going for the diaphragm. That was not in time. I'm so sorry. Well, that sound took us to the end of the round. We have a fantastic game going, 70 to 50. But now we have a chance for a quick intermission, a quick breather, if you will, before we plunge into the one-on-one rapid fire and team lightning rounds. So don't go away. We'll be right back.
WGALA Brainbusters will return after this. Participants on WGALA Brainbusters each receive this drawstring tote bag, and the top four winning teams will share grants totaling $10,000. So good luck, teams. Now, here's Rich with our coaches and alternates.
Well, hi, everyone. I'm so glad you're here because you're just in time to meet Dr. Patricia D'Elia. She is a calculus teacher, and she also teaches geometry, a great math teacher, as I understand, at Lancaster Catholic, a renowned coach here, and we thank you so much for being here. So here's a question I'll throw at you. Lancaster Catholic is a renowned school here in the area. What do you think is one of your school's greatest strength, or strengths, if you will?
Well, Rich, the strength that I'd like to talk about is our amazing and enduring sense of community. I've been so blessed to not just experience that community amongst the students and faculty and staff, but with all their families that I've got to know, and as well as 9 decades now of alumni and family members that are all form part of this beautiful family.
It's great, and I also notice when you come, we are always guaranteed to have a good audience because you attract a lot of people to come and
follow you.
Fantastic. Well, thanks for being here, but we get to meet a new coach. This is a new teacher, first year teacher from Elizabethtown College. Congratulations on that. And you teach science and biology. This is Ray Coral III. And so, just curious, if you weren't a teacher, what might you consider doing?
Well, growing up, one of my major hobbies was fossil trading and collecting. So prior to being a teacher, I wanted to be a paleontologist. But it definitely adds into my teaching of biology and environmental science.
And well, good luck. You're working with a fantastic coach. And if she's an example of your colleagues, I'm sure you're going to have a great lifetime of experience at the school. Peter Nguyen is a senior, and he's today's alternate from Lancaster Catholic. So I know you're a busy student. You're a great student. What do you do outside of school for fun?
So outside of school, I like to do boxing as well as training different martial arts such as Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. And I'm just trying to learn different ways I can improve my health.
Boxing is a fantastic exercise. Do you jump rope a lot as well?
I jump rope a lot, yeah.
I knew it. All right, well, thanks for being here. I'm not going to get in your way. No. Let's head over to Carlisle and meet Mr. Matt Fonstock. Mr. Matt Fonstock teaches gifted at Carlisle. A great coach. You've been a coach of the academic teams for many years, and you always make such great teams, and we really appreciate it. So if you, you're not retired, you're working hard, but if you had a dream vacation, where might that be?
Oh, yeah, I've thought about this. I've been able to travel a lot. I'm really fortunate in that respect, but I have a former student who lives in New Zealand, and he just invited me to his wedding, but it's in February during the school year, so I told him that I can't go, but I promised to get down there and visit him and meet his wife at some point soon.
Yes, New Zealand, I've had the privilege of going there. It's in a magical country. Let's meet today's alternate from Carlisle. We have Justice Maddox, and you're a sophomore, first time here. Thanks so much for being here. You know, I'm always grateful just waking up in the morning, but you have something very specific that you're grateful for.
Yeah, I'm grateful for my family. All four of them are just amazing people. They've helped me so far in life. I don't think I'd be anywhere near here without them. They've helped me so much. I've done, my mom got me into the gifted program. She's fought so many battles for me so I could be here.
And now you're working with this fantastic man.
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. Well, good for you. Thanks for being here. All right, here's the moment we've all been waiting for. We're going to now pit our players one-on-one as we challenge them in today's one-on-one rapid-fire round. It also gives us a chance to talk to our players and find out what's going on in their very busy life. So first, Zach Zuber. Zach Zuber is a sophomore from Lancaster Catholic, and it's great to have you here. And the first question I would like to ask you, you're young, but yet you've also made some decisions about short-term and long-term goals. Would you elaborate on that?
Yeah, I want to go into the field of engineering. My brother's an engineer. He started engineering in college, and he ended up being an engineer as his job once he graduated, so I think it's a good track to follow in.
And it's a good influence from someone like that.
Yes,
do you already
yes.
have schools in mind that you're considering?
Obviously, there's dream schools, but I'll go wherever I know I'll get a good education.
Well, that's a good attitude, but a school will be lucky to have a student like you. Elias Cradle, you are a senior. You did very well in that first round of play. You're a great player, no question about it. But it also helps, and anybody asks me what makes a good player, it's reading. And you're a great reader, so you have a favorite book or a book that you're currently find as one of your favorites. What is that?
Yeah, one of my favorite books is Please Don't Come Back from the Moon by Dean Bacopoulos. It's a book about a suburb of Detroit where all the fathers one day magically leave for the moon and the disillusionment that it creates in their sons. And I like how it's very realistic yet bleak.
And you say it's about a suburb of Detroit?
Yeah.
Because that's where I'm from. That's
oh,
why
okay.
I should know about this book. Well, thank you. So you've enlightened me. Zach and Elias, let's put you 2-1-1. Great game going 70-50, only a slim lead for Lancaster Catholic. And let's see what happens now. In March 2021, Merrick Garland was sworn in for this cabinet position. Which one? Elias.
Secretary of Homeland Security?
No, I'm sorry. Zach, Merrick Garland is the Attorney General of the United States of America. You can find this yellow element in gunpowder, matches, and most proteins on the periodic table. What element is atomic number 16? Elias?
Phosphorus?
Not phosphorus. Good guess, though. Zach, any idea? Symbol S. Element sulfur. And finally, a number of important U.S. cities were built on major rivers. What river runs through Washington, D.C.? Zach.
The Delaware River?
No, sorry. Elias.
No answer.
Oh, we stumped you on the Potomac River. Oh, nobody answered any of those three questions. Let's see what happens now with our next players. We're first going to say hello to Finley Durrett.
Durrett.
Direct. I said that correctly. Thank you very much for correcting me. And, like, you weren't born in the 50s, but yet one of your favorite artists would be more associated with somebody like me.
Right. Yeah, it's Bob Dylan. Based on his influence on modern music, whether it's John Lennon on Rubber Soul or Alex Chilton on Big Star and The Replacements.
He's a classic, and he's going to endure forever, I think.
He will, especially with a record like Blood on the Tracks.
Oh, number one. I appreciate you sharing with that and reminding me of that great music. Atticus Renault, he's a senior from Carlisle, and it's great to have you here, and you're the team's captain from that team. And, you know, we've all tried different foods or maybe gone someplace reluctantly, but you've done something. You were reluctant at first, but now you embraced it 100%.
Yeah, mule riding along the Grand Canyon. I generally prefer the solid ground, but once you get up there and once you, you know, start walking along the rim, it's nice to be up and enjoy the scenery from that vantage point.
And the mules, I mean, they're well trained.
Of course, they're not just going to, like, step over the edge.
Right.
I feel pretty secure.
At least you hope. They are wild animals, nevertheless. All right, Atticus and Finn, don't be wild here as we put you two one-on-one. Mammals belong to a biological class which include 19 living orders. To what order of mammals do human beings belong? Atticus.
Homo sapien.
No, that's incorrect. Sorry. Finn, any idea? Oh boy, we stumped you on primates is the correct answer. In 2017, a group of scientists at Vermont University named a smiley new spider a species after their beloved state senator and 2016 presidential candidate. For whom was it named, Finn?
Bernie Sanders.
You are correct. And finally, this poetic device is found in the line from The Tempest, "Full fathom five thy father lies." Atticus.
Alliteration.
It is alliteration, the repetition of the first consonant in a series of words. 80-60. Now let's meet our final players in today's competition. So first at Lancaster Catholic, let's say hello to Isaac Lynn. And you are a senior, and it's great to have you here. But also, we were talking before the show, like, you have something very specific that you're grateful for as well, and you'd like to share that with us.
Absolutely, yeah. I'm really grateful for my family and especially my three younger siblings. So I'm the oldest of four. My youngest sister is just like a fiery bundle of joy. I love her to death. My brother is inspiringly intelligent and creative. He's invented his own game and written several small like booklets on animals. And then my elder younger sister, 2 years younger than me, is just a wonderful model of self-discipline and religious faith and devotion. So I'm very grateful for her.
Look who they have to model after. My gosh, what a fantastic description of your fantastic family. And I'm sure you can add your parents in there too as being
absolutely
quite extraordinary. Yeah. Sophie Huck is a freshman, ninth grade, the youngest person here. And it's great to have you here. So, like, all of us have an extra $1 million hanging around. And when you do have that extra $1 million, what kind of charity might you consider giving it away to?
Yes, so I would give it to the nonprofit Wolf Sanctuary of PA, which is located in Lititz. It's really incredible. And they take wolves some who were abused, but some who were just as pets, and they give them a new home, and those wolves thrive, and it's very beautiful to see.
Well, it is, and we're taking away their land, you know, development, development, development. Well, Sophie, thanks for caring. Sophie and Isaac, let's get to it with your one-on-one. It is the lightest metal and the third lightest element on the periodic table. What is it? Isaac?
Lithium.
Lithium is correct. Yes, atomic number 3. George Washington's portrait is on the $1 bill. On which US dollar bill will you find Alexander Hamilton's portrait, Sophie?
The $10 bill.
You are correct. And finally, when Queen Elizabeth II died in 2022, she left her beloved horses and what kind of dogs? Sophie again.
Corgis.
Corgis is correct. You are correct. Good for you. You helped your team fantastically, 90-80. Let's pick up the pace now and play today's 60-second lightning round. Atticus, your team is behind at this point, but only by 10 points, so you have the privilege, let's say, of selecting first among these three quizzes. We have In the AM, The Animal Kingdom, and Last Names Only.
We will go with Last Names Only.
Last Names Only. Well, some last names are shared by more than one famous person. For 10 points each, what last name is shared by these sets of first names? Atticus, I take your answer as the team's answer. Elias and Sophie are ready to help you along. We'll put 60 seconds on the clock, which will begin after I finish reading the first question. Good luck, and here we go. Eleanor, Theodore, and Franklin D.
Roosevelt.
Correct. James Earl, Tommy Lee, and Indiana.
Jones.
Correct. Will, Jaden, and Willow.
Smith.
Correct. Abigail, Ansel, John, and
Adams.
John Quincy. Correct. Investor, Warren, and singer-songwriter Jimmy. Yes, it's Buffett. Henry and William, Frank and Jesse.
Right.
James. Flannery, Sinead, and Sandra Day.
O'Connor.
Correct. Richard Henry, Richard Lightfoot, Bruce, and Robert E.
Lee.
Lee is correct. George, DeWitt, Chelsea, and William Jefferson.
Davis.
Clinton, Vanessa, Billy D, Hank, and Tennessee.
Williams.
Poets, Ted and Langston.
Hughes.
Correct. Merv, Kathy, and Blake.
John.
Griffin, George, Benjamin, and William Henry.
Rush.
Harrison, Henry, Harrison, Betty, and Gerald.
Ford
is correct. Ridley, George C., and Sir Walter.
Scott.
Scott is correct. Nat, Ted, Tina, and Kathleen.
Faye.
Kathleen Turner. Well done, a little stumbling, but you got 10 correct. So 100 points came your way. Okay, Carla, you have your work cut out for you within the AM and the Animal Kingdom.
Animal Kingdom.
All of the following answers can be found in the Animal Kingdom. So for 10 points each, identify these people, places, and things that share their name with animals. Now, Finn, I take your answers, the team's answers. Zach and Isaac are ready to help you along. 60 seconds on the clock, which will begin after I finish reading the first question. You're all set? You ready? Okay, here we go. Eldrick T. Woods, golfer.
Tiger.
Correct. March comes in like a lion and goes out like a...
Lamb.
Lamb is correct. This city is home to the Bills and the Sabres.
Buffalo.
Correct. On the stock market, it's the opposite of bear.
Pass.
Bull. Politically, the opposite of a hawk.
Dove.
Correct. In the Catholic Church, they wear red capes and red caps.
Cardinals.
Correct. The highest rank in the Boy Scouts are 2 under par.
Eagles.
Correct. The bird is so strong it can lift girders to the top of tall buildings.
Pass.
A crane, the symbol of the Democratic Party.
Donkey.
Correct. It borders Bulgaria, Greece, Georgia, Armenia, Iran, Iraq, and Syria.
Turkey.
Turkey's correct. It's the large reptile attacked you. You might say, see you later.
Alligator.
Correct. Billy is one. Capricorn is another. A
pass.
Goat. Bull or bullwinkle.
Pass.
Moose. The animal's name can precede bars, business, shines, or wrench.
Monkey.
Monkey is correct. To pester, annoy, or harass. And we're going for Badger, the mascot of the University of Wisconsin. Well done. Some great teamwork was displayed. Also 10 correct. So 100 points came Carlisle's way. Now, it's time to introduce and unveil the bonus Brain Buster category. So during our break, our teams will wager 0 to 25 points based on their knowledge of the ocean. So we'll have the bonus Brain Buster and, of course, the all-important Final Frenzy when WGALA Brain Busters continues following this.
Watch all this season's episodes of WGALA Brain Busters anytime on WGAL.com. Our online home also includes our tournament schedule and a chance to learn more about the show and host Rich Rosen. Go to WGAL.com and click on Brain Busters.
Hello, welcome back. Our teams are neck and neck. It's now time for today's bonus Brain Buster. During our break, our teams wagered 0 to 25 points based on their knowledge of the ocean. Let's head into the News 8 newsroom with Jerry Gish. He has today's question. Jerry, welcome back to Brain Buster.
Thanks, Rich. Now here's your bonus Brain Buster. This French oceanographer, author, and motion picture producer invented the aqualung. Who was he? Again, this French oceanographer, author, and motion picture producer invented the aqualung. Who was he? Good luck with your answer. Now back to Studio B. Rich?
Thanks, Jerry. Good luck, teams. We'll give you about 5 seconds. Okay, we're all set. Pens are closed. Lancaster Catholic on this side of the set. We always start with you. So, Finn, if you would kindly show us what you've put down with 20 points. Peter Dubois, no, I'm sorry, that's incorrect. So we're going to have to deduct 20 points from your score. Atticus, it's up to you. Did you come up with the right answer? Lumiere, no, but only 10 points. Jacques Cousteau is the correct answer. So the scores are now correct at 170 to 170. We have a tie score. It's the Battle of the Brains, and we're going to continue now with today's Final Frenzy. This time we have 20-point questions. In this Tennessee city, you can visit the tomb of James K. Polk, then drive 20 miles to the home of Andrew Jackson. What city calls itself the Athens of the South? Zach.
Nashville.
Nashville does indeed. A tiny Swedish town inspired the names of four elements, numbers 39, 65, 68, and 70. What is the name of the town? Atticus.
Stockholm.
No, sorry, that's incorrect. Any idea from Lancaster Catholic? We stumped you on Yaterbi. Yaterbi, Yaterbian, Erbian, and Terbian were the elements. In Longfellow's poem, Miles Standish persuades his friend John to carry a proposal to Priscilla Mullins. What is John's last name? Elias.
Smith.
Not Smith, no, sorry, incorrect. Any idea, Lancaster Catholic? We stumped you on he's John Alden. This landlocked South American country has a navy and a coast guard. Its boats patrol the waters of Lake Titicaca. What country shares the lake with Peru? Atticus.
Venezuela.
No, not Venezuela, sorry. Where's Finn?
Bolivia.
Bolivia does indeed. You are correct. In 1810, he married the Austrian princess Marie Louise, daughter of Emperor Francis I, less than a year after his marriage to the Empress Josephine had been annulled. Who was the groom?
Napoleon.
Again, Napoleon was correct again. The ancient kingdom of Kush and Nubia once included Egypt and was eventually conquered by the Ethiopians. In what modern African country was it located? Ifin.
Sudan.
Sudan, correct again. The original design was changed by Michelangelo. Michelangelo's design was changed by Giacomo della Porta.
Sistine Chapel.
That's incorrect, Elias. So sorry. What famous dome was the result, Lancaster Catholic? We stumped you on St. Peter's Basilica in the Vatican. This Shakespearean king is described as that bottled spider, that foul bunchback toad. Who is this unpleasant title character and royal villain, Atticus?
King Lear.
Not he, no, sorry. Lancaster Catholic. Finn.
Hamlet?
No, sorry, it's Richard III. In this book, the number 7 is used 54 times, referring to churches, seals, heads, trumpets, angels, bowls, and plaques.
Finn. Revelation.
The book of Revelation, yes. These wave-like contractions of the intestine move food through the digestive system. What is this movement called? Oh, we stumped you on peristalsis, founded in London. That's now takes us to the end of the round and to the end of the game. With a fantastic performance in that final round, it looks like we're going to see Lancaster Catholic for round two, but we hope to see you in just a few short moments.
Scorekeeping for WGAL 8 Brainbusters, presented by Jennings College Consulting, where students discover the right college fit for the future. We'll return after this. Welcome back to WGAL 8 Brainbusters, the Susquehanna Valley's longest-running high school quiz show. Once again, here's your host, Rich Rosen.
Well, hello, welcome back. Wasn't that a fantastic competition? I do have to acknowledge Finn's performance in that last round of play. He really came alive and did really well. So we're going to see Lancaster Catholic again for round two. We say goodbye to Carlisle, but I hope you had as much fun as we did witnessing your performance. We have another great game coming up on another edition of WGAL 8 Brainbusters. We'll see you then. So long for now. Goodbye, everyone.